full. I set the rule with them day one. I said, folks, I cannot spend time to say goodbye to you every Sunday morning. I have to get over here. And this morning I was late because Nancy was standing out there saying, they're waiting on you. Told you she kept me straight. They loved me and they fed me with prayer shawl. Just like you love and you feed me with the things that you do and the things that you say. So I know, whether you're willing to admit it or not, you know how to feed people. How many of you have been here through two pastors? Three pastors? Four pastors? Five pastors? Six pastors? Seven pastors? Huh? Can you go to eight? Okay. So between seven and eight. Y'all have, in this group of people, fed eight pastors. Eight. And you're going to get another one. And you're going to feed that pastor, too. You might not feed that pastor ham hocks and collard greens, because y'all know I like country food. But you're going to feed that pastor in ways that that pastor needs to be fed. And you get to make a choice about how you do that. One is, you can actually show that pastor you love him. You don't have to even say it. A hug will do. A hug goes a long way. Y'all know that. If you got something to say about the pastor, don't say it to your best friend. Say it to the pastor. You and the pastor can work it out. I promise. Because you know how to feed, which comes out of compassion. And the pastor knows how to feed too. And that comes out of compassion. And the last thing is, when you're feeding this new pastor, when you're loving this new pastor, I ask that you do it the same way you've done it with me. You get a couple of choices. You can either do this. We really like each other, don't we? Lots and lots. There's what, almost six? Well, my arm and your arm aren't quite 6 feet long. If we really stretched it, could be. But there's like 4 feet between us. Is this a really good relationship? Not so much. This is an acquaintance relationship. But this isn't. And that's taking it a step further. Relationships aren't built like this. They may start like that, but then they get closer and they get closer and they get closer and they get closer.
How sweet it is.
But all God's children saying it. when you're sick and you're in a crisis. Love's going to be listening to Nancy when she says, I don't think so. And when they disagree, they kind of, Nick, you're sure? 2 days later, you're sure? I've worn her down a little time. That's what this text is really all about. We become the face of Christ. When we go to the communion table today, you're going to eat the body and blood of Christ, right? Right. That's what we as Lutherans understand. That is the body and blood of Jesus Christ. Today, I invite you to eat it so that you may become it. You know that saying, you are what you eat? If you eat nothing but lemon meringue pie, you're going to have a pie-shaped rear end, a pie-shaped face, pie-shaped hands. It just goes on and on. And you can wear a meringue, lemon meringue colored dress. If you are what you eat, then feeding the new pastor is going to be easy. Feeding the new pastor is going to be easy anyway. Because we've been in this process. Kim probably kept wondering when I was saying last week. 13, 14. I actually went and looked at the calendar because your math and my math weren't the same. You're right. I've been here for like 12 and a half, 13 months. But our process has been going on for 15. Almost 16. And the process was actually taking place before that. God has been stirring in this church through the Holy Spirit, in and out, weaving, for almost 2 years now. Why? To prepare you, to prepare a new person, to teach me some things, and for it all to come back together again, where you're feeding the pastor and others, and the new pastor is feeding you and others. Don't keep them at arm's length. It'll never work. It's kind of like being married. Take it serious. Compassion feeds. And I know that not only are you compassionate, but you're passionate about this place and about your service. Keep moving forward and caring. Because you know what? You get what you pay for. If I treated Paul this way, or this way, how do you think he's going to treat me? The exact same way I treat him. But if I treat him that way, guess what I get back? Exactly what I get. Y'all got it in you. You got it in you.